This is the new fashions for 2021. I'm gonna be dazzled when I get out of here.
He's going in and out of lucidness, and he has a button that he pushes.
I think it's been time to push the button. Where's my pain pill?
Here's the button, honey.
I know that button.
Right?
I know that button.
Neil Patrick Harris taking it back to his Doogie Howser days, playing a little doctor to his husband, David, who is recovering from surgery and doing well.
Neil is joining us now. Neil, great to see you.
Who are you guys?
You look good, Neil.
Before we get into this cozy situation that you're involved in right there, how's the husband doing? I know that button. That was a good time right there.
I don't think he remembers much of what he said, although I posted it on social media, so right. I think he's probably seen it.
So, Neil, of the two of you, I always love this with a couple. Who's the better patient?
Oh, that's a very interesting question. Both David and I are pretty driven. And when either one of us is sick, we get cranky quickly because we just want to get out of bed and keep on doing things. But I think David's probably a better patient.
Especially there.
He's very sweet, you know. He just had spinal surgery on some discs that was sort of a long time coming. It wasn't a sudden accident that he had had or anything. So so in his recovery, he has been so lovely to me, to the nurses and the doctors at Newark Presbyterian. And it's lovely to see in his recovery that he's staying as positive as he is.
Now, Hoover, I don't know if you know this, but I have I've happened to know Neil for, my God, since we were little kids.
From
really,
Doogie?
From way back in the day. Prior to that, we had like the same acting coach.
What?
And he was really good friends with Ed Alonzo, who played Max over on Saved by the Bell, because Neil's quite the magician. That's another, he's like an incredible magician. And so, is that still a passion of yours, Neil?
Oh man, I love magic. I crow about it as much as I possibly can. It's a tricky thing within the pandemic right now, right? Because you can't see many magic shows live because of the lack of interaction, but there's a lot of online opportunity. I've known you, brother, since well before Doogie. I remember going to Universal Studios and seeing you in preparation for Circus of the Stars. You were doing a tightrope.
And the black spandex.
You were rule-worthy, even back then, Mario Lopez in the onesie.
It's
for the
so
win.
Funny, but it's funny, even as a kid, because I was like 15 years old, and I remember you came from, correct me if I'm wrong, Albuquerque, New Mexico, right? The hometown, New Mexico. And you could just tell he was a super sharp and really intelligent kid. And
I'm
obviously
just
great
geeking
actor.
Out. This is so cool right now to think of you two way back when, right? Little kids.
Well, you know, it's tough. And Neil can tell you it's very tough to transition like as a former child actor into adulthood. But my man's done quite well for himself. So kudos to you. I always root for former child actors.
Love it.
So that's cool.
And Neil, the story, if this
I'm
is
enjoying
true
this,
or not,
by the way.
Because Mario's got to meet everybody as well. But is it true you spent one Thanksgiving with Burt Reynolds?
Yes, Burt Reynolds and Lonnie Anderson. So back in the day, I did a television movie with Lonnie Anderson where she drowned me in the swimming pool and murdered me. And then I got to hang out with her husband and did an episode of a show he did called B.L. Stryker. And I was there filming right over Thanksgiving, and Bert and Lonnie were incredibly gracious and nice and invited us and my parents to their house. And we thought that would be 30, 40 people at the big Burt Reynolds party. And it was us and them in their kitchen.
Awesome.
Like
that's the bandit.
Of us sitting around having Thanksgiving together. It was fantastic.
Oh, yeah, I would have freaked out. Smokey and the bandit right there. That would have been awesome right there.
Totally.
Now, Neil, I've been sipping on this really delicious drink.
That?
And I know this is Bailey's Irish cream, but it's a light version. This happens to be my mom's favorite drink in the world.
It is?
She has it.
I'm a big Bailey's fan, too. So they've had the Bailey's original Irish cream. This is Bailey's Deliciously Light. They asked me to talk about it. It's a new product. It's coming out. It's 40% less sugar, 40% less calories. But they're doing this great initiative, which is just for regular people, no big charity. It's called having light moments, and you can send a light moment to someone that you care about that is bummed out or that just needs a smile.
And
they'll give product and some other cool stuff. And I did one. I filmed a little commercial, sent one to my friend Michael, I think it's good to talk about stuff that's positive, paying it forward to people that you care about, you know?
I agree. And you've got the perfect setup there,
yeah,
too,
look
my
at
friend.
Neil.
With the fireplace and the nice sweater.
The sweater. I feel like you need a pipe. Yeah. Maybe a pipe coming
right,
out in a storybook.
He's got right. He's going to read me a story.
Ascot.
An ascot. That's what's missing.
And a bloodhound. This is fantastic what we're creating.
This is how I picture you with maybe the kids in the corner reading quietly, yeah, right? That's Neil Patrick Harris.
How are the kids doing, by the way, Neil?
The kids are great. They're in the other room, and I demanded that they be quiet while I finish this.
Please have them run in. I'd love to see them. They are so cute. I always love especially to see what they're doing up at Halloween. So what are they up to these days?
Well, they're 10 years old. They're both in the fourth grade, and they had been doing remote schooling, and now they're back into the regular school system as of I think the last week. Oh. They started doing that, so it's been nice for them. It's interesting to see the mask wearing all day and the social distancing all the time, but even far apart in desks, they're still able to have some social interaction. I think feel more like they're actually in school as opposed to just being in a room that they're calling school. And so, yeah, they're doing good. They're thriving. Proud of them.
Lucky kids. I'm jealous.
I'm jealous too.
Mine, unfortunately, are stuck with me as a teacher. So they're
not
learning
going
nothing.
Well.
It's tough because when I started with our kids in regular school, I wanted to be sort of teacher from home, you know, as a parent. But we were told by our teachers, let the teachers teach. Yeah. You guys handle the parenting stuff. But now we're in a different time. So I was having to do both and be stern as a teacher, but you don't want to be stern as a parent or vice versa. I don't know. It was very complicated. So hats off to you both. It's tricky.
We want to say cheers to you.
Yes.
Neil Patrick Harris.
Salute, my
looking
friend.
Looking so good in front of his fire.
Good to see you, Neil.
Come over anytime.
Neil. Oh, that
hopefully
was so
we'll see
fun.
Him in person. Big thanks to Neil Patrick Harris.